A Halloween special with Hokoyo and friends.
Look, it's Pato and Pocoyo. Hello. What are you doing here?
Trick or treat.
Oh, I see. You're going trick-or-treating, and you're going into that eerie house to get some candy.
Trick-or-treat.
Pato, Pocoyo is right. If you want candy, you have to be brave. That's it. Very brave, Pato.
Wow, that's very, homey. So now what shall we do?
Trick or treat!
Okay, let's go in and get some candy. Pato's right, I think. Maybe we should go back where we came from and...
Scary.
Are you saying that we're scared? Well done, Pato. Very daring. Now, get one of those candies and let's get out of here. That's creepy. Maybe we'd better take a look around. Pato, go upstairs. Pato also thinks it's better to take a look upstairs. What's that? Oh, wow. It's a crow. Oh, this is so spooky.
Baby bird.
Oh, so it was baby bird. You see, Pato, there's nothing to be afraid of. Looks like Pato wants to go on his own. Come on, Pato. Don't get angry. It's Halloween. It's normal to get a couple of frights, especially in such a creepy house as this. What's up, Pato? Oh, it's a lift. And there's someone inside. Oh, it's Ellie, Nina, Lula, and Roberto. Oh, Pato. Pato, wait, where are you going? Pato, let me explain.
Oh no, it's a ghost!
Pato, calm down. I'm sure there must be an explanation for all this. Yes, take a bath and relax. That's it. A hot tub will help. Oh, Fred, it was you! Pato, wait! Oh, no, not the ghost again! It's Sleepy Bird!
Sleepy Bird!
You see, Pato, it can all be easily explained. It was all our friends dressed up.
Pato, behind you. It's... It's real ghosts. And they look quite friendly.
Everybody knows it. It's the fantastic little haunted house.
Haunted house.
Haunted house.
Haunted house.
Haunted house.
Where all the ghosties
are all very friendly.
Come to the little haunted house.
Haunted house. House.
Where all of the monsters joke and
laugh and have some fun.
Skeletons dancing till they're done.
Great! This has been a frightfully fun experience. Bye-bye. See you soon.
Hello, everyone. All dressed up for Halloween, I see. Hello, Nina. And where's your costume? You don't know what Halloween is? Well, Halloween is a special night where everyone has fun trying to scare each other. See? A scary, mad mummy! A frightening wolf man! And a spooky ghost pirate! What's that, Potto? You're going to tell a scary story? All right, Potto, let's hear it. Once upon a time, there was an old pirate. He roamed the darkest dark ocean, carrying a trunk that was full to the brim with yummy candies. Suddenly, from out of the scary fog, a ghost ship The ghost pirate sent a giant octopus to steal the trunk. Turning all the candies into really terrifying ghost candies. Oh well, I suppose that wasn't so scary, was it? Pocoyo, would you like to try?
Yes!
Once upon a time, there was an ordinary boy who, when the moon was full, became the terrible, hair-raising, unbearable wolf boy. Well, the wolf boy just wants to play fetch.
Ah!
Would you like to try?
There once was a mummy who went to the cemetery one dark and stormy night
to have a lovely picnic with her dolls.
And when a strange and haunting music started to play, they all had a zombie dance party.
Well, Nina definitely isn't scared by that. Oh my! Who can that be? Trick or treat! Now that was a good scare!
Happy Halloween!
Pocoyo's Christmas Carol. Look, it's Ellie. Hello, Ellie. And here come Pocoyo and Pato. Hi, guys. Caterpillar and Baby Bird have also come. Great! Oops! Wow! It's so much fun to play in the snow! Snowball fight! Great! Idea, Pocoyo. Let's play with the ball.
Yay!
In the snow. Pato, you're an ace! Ellie's right. You don't have to get angry, guys. Well, at least they're friends again. Uh-oh. Guys, come on, just stop it. You don't need to fight.
It's mine!
Thank you. This is not the time to be upset. Ellie says that you should make up with a hug. Come on. Hug. Just one hug, please? Come on, Pocoyo. Say something nice to Pato.
It's mine!
Hey, I'm afraid this isn't working, Ellie. It looks like Ellie has an idea. A tail? Very good, Ellie!
Yay!
A Christmas carol. This is the story of Mr. Scrooge, an old miser and cold-hearted creditor who only cared about his money. He spent many hours alone, counting his coins and becoming bitter and aloof. Mr. Scrooge despised everyone. People on the street used to run away from his presence. Nobody dared to speak to him or to knock on his door. Old Scrooge hated everything, but he loathed Christmas above all.
It's an immense waste of time, and especially money.
Lonesome, feeding his hatred and anger, he didn't allow the Christmas spirit to go beyond the doorstep of his office.
Bah! Humbug!
On a cold Christmas night, while Mr. Scrooge was sleeping reclusively in his bleak house, he was visited by the ghost of his late partner, Mr. Marley. Mr. Marley told him about his dreadful fate, cursed to wander the earth because of the greed that had ruled his life. And he announced that three ghosts would visit Mr. Scrooge during the next three nights. The ghost of Christmas past, the ghost of Christmas present, and the ghost of Christmas yet to come. First to arrive was the ghost of Christmas past, who made old Scrooge relive memories of his childhood. The next night, the ghost of Christmas present appeared and showed him the miseries of his current life, isolated and hated by everyone because of his greed. The third night arrived the ghost of Christmas yet to come, who showed him the terrible destiny that would await him if he didn't change his attitude. Scrooge woke up startled from what he thought was a nightmare, but he felt relieved. Something had changed within himself. From that day on, Scrooge decided to dedicate his life to making others happy. And he became a generous and lively person who shared his wealth and newfound joy with everyone. Ellie, that was a wonderful story. And I guess we've all learned something from its moral, right? I wonder what else we can do to please these two. The storytelling has given Ellie a good idea. Well, I think it's time to go to bed. There have been enough fights for today.
Yay!
It's mine!
rest of the story. And she has come to announce the visit of the ghosts of Christmas past. We are now in the past, when you were barely babies. Baby Pato and Baby Pocoyo. It looks like on Christmases past you were good friends. Visited by the ghost of Christmas present. Oh my, you're a big ghost indeed. The ghost of Christmas present says he is tired of all your fights. So he's going to show you something on his sophisticated device.
Mine!
You see?
Mine.
You're fighting all the time.
It's mine! It's mine!
You should make peace. Wow, he's gone.
Mine.
Ellie's ghost asks if you're going to stop fighting. Then now you will receive the visit of the ghost of Christmas yet to come. Sleepy bird, are you the ghost of Christmas yet to come? Okay. How scary. Pocoyo, I think we are in the future.
And Pato?
Pocoyo, I'm afraid Pato is not going to be here next Christmas. You argued so much that he's left. But before leaving, Pato left you this gift.
Pogoyo?
It's your ball. Guys, it seems like everything has been a nightmare.
Pato!
Ellie, Pogoyo and Pato want to tell you something important.
I'm sorry, Ellie.
Great! We're all friends again.
Yay!
It seems that Pato and Pogoyo want to apologize to everyone.
Let's play with the ball.
That's great! Friends again.
Oh no. Oh dear.
And here ends this charming story. Merry Christmas, everyone. Bye-bye. See you soon. Hello, everybody. Are you going someplace? So, you're going to the amusement park. What fun! Oh, my. I guess you'll have to wait for the next bus. Here it is. Well, don't worry. There's still one more bus today. And here it comes. Oh. And that was the last bus. What a shame. No amusement park today. But maybe you can find something that's just as much fun.
Appa!
What do you have in mind, Nina? done. That was great! What's next, Pocoyo? What fun! But it looks like Pato isn't feeling so well. Now it's Ellie's turn! Awesome! You've made an obstacle course to play on! Don't worry! You can do it! Pato wants to show you his idea for a new ride. Roberto, I think Pato needs some help. Be careful! You're flying too high! Congratulations, guys! With a little imagination, you've got your own amusement park at home! Bye-bye, everyone! Hi, Ellie. What are you doing? Painting? Of course, you're painting the house pink, a beautiful color. Oh, yes, very beautiful. I mean, the most beautiful color in the whole wide world. Hello, Pocoyo. Hello, Pato.
Hey!
Ellie's still got quite a lot to paint. Maybe she could use some help.
Paint!
I think perhaps she loves some help.
Paint!
Well, Ellie, you've certainly made a very pink house. What's up? There, a nice can of pink. Pato, I'm afraid Ellie's not happy with your color. Ellie insists you paint the house pink.
No, blue.
Pato's painted your portrait on the wall. But Ellie, it can't be that bad to paint with other colors. A pink roof, Ellie. But Pocoyo! Oh no! Pato! Guys, maybe you should... Easy now, guys. Wait a minute. If you don't calm down, you'll never solve this. What a mess. Good idea, Ellie. Each of you can paint a part. Wonderful! That's it! Now the house is pink! beautiful. See you next time. Hello, Ellie. Is this your bedroom? You've got a bed and a wardrobe. Great. Hello, Potto. What's that, Potto? You say your bedroom is better? You have a lamp. Nice.
My better. Bedroom. My better.
You think your bedroom is better, Pocoyo?
Uh-huh. Toy box.
Oh, I see. You have a toy box. Oh, dear. Now, a quiet moment with Sleepy Bird. Hello, Pocoyo. A bed? Sofa.
Sofa.
A table. Now, Pocoyo.
Stop fighting!
Can you tell me what that is?
Wardrobe!
It's a wardrobe!
Can you tell me what that is? Can you tell me what that is?
It's a toy box!
Toy box! Hooray!
Not again!
Number menu!
Ah, time for a nice lunch. It looks like Pato is ready to order. 9 olives.
9 olives!
Oh dear. Well, how about 9 raspberries instead? Nine raspberries. Ah, Poor Pato. Can you tell Pato how many hearts there are?
Nine hearts.
That's right. Nine. If only one bedroom had a wardrobe, a lamp, and a toy box. Look, it's Ellie's wardrobe. And there's Pato's lamp. And Pocoyo's toy box. And a bed. This is the best bedroom ever.
In my bedroom, I have a lamp that gives me light, a wardrobe with my clothes in it. I have a toy box with my toys inside, and the bed where I sleep.
Wardrobe, lamp, toy box, bed, table, sofa.
In my bedroom, I have a lamp that gives me light, a wardrobe with my clothes in it. I have a toy box with my toys inside, and the bed where I sleep.
Hello, Pato. What a lovely living room. There's a sofa, a table, a rug, and a TV. Wonderful! Oh, look! Your friends are here!
Hi, Pato!
Pato, that wasn't nice.
The Martian Brothers Show!
TV. Radio.
Radio, 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 radio.
Radio, it's a radio.
Phone. Ah, popcorn. Delicious.
Hello!
Pato, your friends are here. Where is Caterpillar?
The table.
She's on the table.
Where is Pocoyo?
He's on the sofa.
And where is Lula? That's right.
Wheel of Colors. welcome to the show. Here we go. And today's colour is... purple! All right, let's all look for something purple. Go! Something purple. All right, let's see your pictures. A purple ball. A purple umbrella. And a purple cup. Good job! Now keep looking for purple things. A purple car. Perfect. A purple aubergine. Beautiful. And this? Do you know what it is? A purple alien! Hooray for purple!
Pato, that's not nice. They are your friends. I wonder where your friends are, Pato. They aren't having much fun. Pocoyo, Pato would like you to sit on the sofa. That's right, Lula. Sit on the rug. And Caterpillar sits on the table. What fun! Now everyone can watch TV together.
Welcome to my living room, my friends have come to be here with me. We all watch the TV, one sits on the table, one lies on the rug, some sit on the sofa. Sofa, one sits on the table, one lies on the rug. We all watch the TV.
Hi, Ellie. A house? How lovely. The door? The roof? The roof is on top of the house. And a window. Terrific! Hello, Pato. Hello, Pocoyo.
House!
A house, that's right. You must be very careful. It's Ellie's house. Now, Pocoyo, Pato, be careful. Oh, dear. Oh, this is bad. The Martian Brothers Show! Lamp.
Lamp!
It's a lamp!
key. Phone. Can you tell Pocoyo and Pato what that is?
Roof!
It's the roof!
Roof!
The roof! Very good! Can you tell them what this is?
Door!
It's the door!
Door!
The door! Right! And what's this?
Window!
It's the window!
Window!
Right!
Rebuild!
Good idea! This is not good. Poor Ellie. Animals, dot to dot. Hello, Pocoyo. Oh, I see. You're concentrating on that picture. Do you know what it is? Why don't we connect the dots to finish the drawing? How about now, Pocoyo? Do you know what animal it is? No? Let's connect more dots. Now do you know what animal it is, Pocoyo? Can you tell Pocoyo what it is?
Snake! It's a snake!
Snake!
Yes, it's a snake. Well done. That's better. The roof goes on top of the house. The window. The window goes there. Great! And the door. The door goes there. Perfect.
We did it!
Yay!
What a beautiful house!
Yay!
House now. We're going to need some walls and a roof. We also need a door. And then we need a window.
House! Roof! Wall! Door!
We're going to build a house now. We're going to need some walls and a roof. We also need a door. And then we need a window.
Oh my! A pirate flag? Our friends seem different. They have a telescope. Pocoyo has an eye patch.
A map!
And they have a map. Oh, I see. They're pirates.
Treasure chest!
They're pirates looking for a treasure chest. Oh, they're piranhas. Be careful, Pirate Pocoyo. Pocoyo's Fairy Tales. Hello, Pocoyo. What's that?
Story!
Ah, it looks like Pocoyo has a story for you. Once upon a time, there was a dinosaur who wanted to go to an island. He took a ship. But then, the ship started to sink. So he took a boat. But then the boat started to sink. So he started to swim. When he got to the island, he phoned his friend, the ant. He asked the ant to come to the island too. So the ant took a ship. But the ship started to sink. So the ant took a boat. But the boat started to sink. So the ant started to swim. When the ant got to the island, they made a lovely sandcastle and had lots of fun. The end. Our pirates are still looking for the treasure. I think Pato sees something. Can you tell Pocoyo what Pato saw?
The treasure chest!
He saw the treasure chest.
Can you tell Pocoyo what Pato used to see the treasure chest?
The telescope!
He used the telescope.
What do you see, Pocoyo? What is that?
Monster!
The treasure chest is guarded by a monster. How will our pirates ever get the treasure?
Wheel of Colors! Welcome to the show! Today's color is... orange! Everyone, look for something orange. Something orange. What can you find? All right, let's see your pictures. An orange tent. An orange flag. An orange block. Good. Keep searching for orange things. A carrot. Yes, it's orange. An orange key. Excellent. And this, do you know what it is?
An orange alien.
An orange alien. Very good. Hooray for orange! Hooray! The pirates have landed! Oh, the piranhas are coming too! Uh-oh!
Treasure chest!
Oh no! The monster is awake! Run, Pocoyo, run! And the piranhas! Run, Pato, run! Oh dear! Phew! Now open the treasure chest! Oh! Can you tell me what that is? Another treasure hunt! Ahoy, Pocoyo!
We are the Great Little
and pirates. We have a map and a telescope. We are the great little pirates. We're sailing the sea with our pirate flag. We are the pirates in search of a treasure chest. We have a map that tells where it is. We are the pirates in search of a treasure chest, looking through that telescope.
Treasure chest!
We are the pirates in search of a treasure chest. We have a map that tells where it is. We are the pirates in search of a treasure chest, looking through that telescope.
A long, long time ago, in a galaxy very, very far away, Christmas morning was about to arrive for the little baby angry alien. Happy Christmas, baby alien. Like every Christmas day, Daddy and Baby Alien opened the Christmas presents together. But just after that, Daddy Alien disappeared because he had to go on a secret mission. Year after year, the little baby alien had to play with his presents all alone. Until one Christmas, while he was looking through his telescope at another planet, he saw a Christmas tree with loads of presents. Wait a second, angry alien. You aren't going to do something naughty, are you? On Christmas Day? Oh no! Now look here! You're not thinking of destroying all these presents, are you?
Thank you.
Oh, Pato says that this is the tie that he wanted for Christmas. Maybe the names on the presents just got mixed up. So it was that Angry Alien was happy for the first time at Christmas. After all, the best thing isn't the presents, but to have people to share them with. Merry Christmas, everyone!
Hello, Pocoyo!
Hello.
Oh. What's this?
Duh.
Yes. I wonder what's behind it. Do you think Pocoyo should open it and find out? A door to the sky? Now that's unusual.
Pato! Pato Sky, look!
Oh my! I wonder what happened to the sky. Yeah, I think Pato wants to keep watching the fish. Can any of you tell Pocoyo where Pato went?
He went through the door!
Pato, there you are! Pocoyo is looking for you! Wait! Oh, Pocoyo, you just missed him! Pato! Pato, wait! Oh, dear. Pocoyo, I'm afraid you just missed him again! Oh, my. That is one strange door. Try again. Did you see him?
Pato?
Yes, he was just there. There he is again! Oh my! Another door! More doors? Oh dear! Now, Pocoyo, you can't give up. That sounded familiar. Can any of you tell Pocoyo who made that sound?
Pato!
I believe you're right. It sounded like Pato. Perhaps you ought to get some help, Pocoyo.
Ellie!
Hello, Ellie.
Pato, Pato!
Hooray! You found him! What's that, Ellie? You're working on something? What could Ellie be working on that's so important? That's what Ellie was busy with. She was preparing a party. What fun! Hooray for Pocoyo! Hooray for not giving up! Bye-bye! See you soon!
Hello, Pato. Oh, I'm sorry. You'd like some peace and quiet, am I right? Well then, I'll be absolutely sure to... Ah. Right. Quiet. Ooh, a new mobile phone. It looks really cool. What do you plan to do with it? The first thing to do is to choose a good ringtone. Very catchy. It looks like you're not the only one who likes your ringtone, Pato. There, that's done it. Alone again. Ah, a nice quiet stroll alone. It's Ellie calling. Oh, I see. Ellie called you because she wanted your phone to make that ringtone again. Well, I can't say I blame her. It's Pocoyo. He must want to hear that. Oh, Pato, do come back. That song is just so catchy. You've set your phone to vibrate, which means you won't be bothered by anyone anymore. I suppose that makes sense. Look, all your friends are here. Why don't you put your phone down and go join them? Pato! Your phone! No one's calling? That's strange. No one again? Then where's that buzzing sound coming from? it's just sleepy birds snoring. Looks like it was a false alarm. Oh, I'm sorry, Pato. All the cake is gone. But there are plenty of carrot sticks. Pato, what is that you're playing on your phone? Well, that seems fun. But wouldn't you have more fun playing with your friends? No, don't throw it in the lake. Pato, it looks like Fred needs your phone. That's all right, isn't it? Why, it looks like he ordered a pizza. And Ellie's texted all your friends. There's that catchy tune. Isn't it wonderful, Pato? A dance party with pizza. What fun! Goodbye, everybody!